Hey traders, Philip Tigerson here from Stock Market Strategy. Before I start, I just want to say that trading involves risk and hard work, so please do your own due diligence before trading for real money. Today I'm going to talk about moving averages. I will give you some background information about moving averages, and then with the help of some charts show the four different things moving averages can be used for. Finally, I will give you some ideas how to trade using moving averages in conjunction with other indicators and or chart analysis. If you go to our website www.stock-market-strategy.com, you'll find a tab called Education, Technical Analysis, and Moving Averages. Here you'll find a written summary about moving averages, including some charts showing you how to use the moving averages in conjunction with chart analysis. This is made to make it easier for you to keep track of the information. You might even print this page out so you can have it in front of you while writing your trading plan and or backtesting the idea shown here. Moving averages, also known as MAs, has existed since the beginning of technical analysis and is one of the most popular tools in trading. They're easily calculated, which is a key factor in its popularity, because in the old days you didn't have automated charting packages to do all the calculation for you. MAs are mostly calculated by using the closing price of the bar, but it's also possible to calculate by using opening price or high-low price. This bar could be a tick bar, minute bar, daily bar, and so forth. In the early days, people only used daily charts. Therefore, many people refer to MA as daily MAs. But since the introduction of intraday trading, people are now referring to MAs as a period value MA, like 20 period MA. MA works as dynamic support resistance. Traders often keep an eye on these MAs, which partly results in self-prophecy. Simple moving average, the SMA, or the exponential moving average, the EMA, is the most common MA. Simple moving average is created by calculating the average price of a stock over a certain amount of bars. So a 20 simple moving average on a daily chart will show you the average price for the last 20 daily bars. So here we will have the average price of the last 20 bars. One of the problems with moving averages is that they are lacking the price. Exponential moving average is challenging this problem by putting more weight on the recent price bars. This means that the EMA will adapt faster to the current rally or drop, giving the traders a heads up. MA smoothen out the data, making it easier to spot the trend. Here you see the MA is upsloping, so the trend is up all the way. But without the MA, it could have been difficult to see that the trend stayed up during this time here where the price trades a little bit sideways. MA also helps you filtering out the noise in volatile market. For example, here you see some big swings, and this might make you think that this could be the beginning of a new down move. But the MA stays upward, so the trend is still up, helping us filtering out the noise. Which kind of MA should you use, and which length should you choose? This is of course a personal preference of the trader. But I've asked myself, why am I using a moving average? I'm using a moving average because I want to smooth out the data, making it easier for me to identify the trend, and second, to filter out noise. So it makes sense for me to use a simple moving average for this purpose instead of the EMA, because the EMA adapts faster, giving me a little bit more noise or unsmoothened data. But after I've done my analysis, which is looking at my MA and see that it's downsloping, so the trend is down, I want a quick entry to the downside. Here, I want a quicker entry than what the SMA give me, so I use the EMA for this purpose. It gets me in faster, giving me a better profit and risk reward. The length is something you have to backtest and forward test yourself, because you might be trading a different instrument or a different time frame than me. I've chosen a 50 moving average and 20 moving average because these are used a lot in the industry. MAs can be used for four things: trend, value, entry, and stop loss. I'm going to show you all four, but I'll start with trend. MAs are a great tool for helping you determine the trend of a stock or future or whatever other instrument you want to trade. First, you can say that the slope of the MA determines your trend. So when the slope of the MA is down, you got a downtrend. When it's sideways, you got sideways market. And when it's up sloping, you got an uptrend. Second, You can also say that if the price is underneath the MA, you got a downtrend. The price is staying relative underneath the MA here. When we come to this point here, we're seeing equal price action on each side. So you consider this sideways. And then when we see the majority of the price, or in this case, all of the prices above the MA, the trend is up. You can use two MAs to help you determine the trend, a short and a long. You say, for example, that when the short one, in this case a 20 moving average, is underneath the long one, which is a 50, the trend is down. So in this case, the trend is down all the way until this point. Then you can consider the trend to be up. Here's a second way to use moving averages. I call it value. Whenever the price is near the MA, it will have a fair value and could be placed to initiate a position in the stock or whatever other instrument you want to trade. Of course, the word fair has to be taken as a loose term. But after a rally, you see the rally here, and the price pulls back to the MA, and here as well, you could imagine that the last buyer has bought at this average price, and therefore it seems fair. Here's the third way to use moving averages. You can use it for entries. Many traders use MAs for entries, and this can be done in several different ways. First, a crossover of two MAs. Of course, you want to go with the trend, so you don't take the crossover to the downside, you only take it to the upside. So here's a crossover, so this could be a long signal. Here's another crossover. This is another long signal. The second way to use MAs for entries could be a close above the MA, or under for that matter. But in this case, we do have an uptrend, so we only want to take long plays. So we're looking for closes above the MA. Preferable after an X amount of bars closing underneath, because we do need some pullback for us to give an entry. So a close above the MA here could be an entry. A close above here could be an entry, or this one could be an entry. And here's the third way to enter using MA. You can simply put a limit order at the MA. For example here, a limit order, and you would be in the trade. Here you could place a limit order, and that's your entry. Here's the fourth way to use MAs, stop loss and trailing stops. Earlier I told you that MA works as dynamic support resistance, so it makes sense for us to use the MA for stop losses. You want to place your stop underneath support or your stop above resistance. For trailing stops, MAs are really good. They stay objective and don't know how much profit you have on your open position. Let's assume you were in this trade from somewhere down here. You see it climbs, you see the open profit. Every time it pulls back, you get nervous. You want to book that profit. But by using an MA as a trailing stop, you would have stayed in this trade all the way up here. So the MA helps you stay objective. Okay, you've seen how to use moving averages for trend determination, to find value points, to get an entry signal, and use for stop loss. But you can also use moving averages together with other indicators or chart patterns. Here's an example of how to use MA with chart patterns. I first identify the trend. I see that my MA is upsloping, so the trend is up. I'll only take long plays. Second, I look for patterns which occur above the MA. This tells me the trend is strong since that the consolidation all happens above the MA. And third, my entry, which is a close outside the trend line on this triangle. And here is a close above the trend line in this triangle. This ends today's video. I hope you enjoyed it.